Good evening, good evening, good evening, everyone. Good evening, good evening, good evening, everyone. Moderators, if you can hear my voice clearly, put a one in the chat box. Put a one in the chat room if you can hear my voice clearly. If you can hear my voice clearly, put a one in the chat room. Awesome. Shout out to Margaret. Love you. Thank you for getting on the stream tonight. Put a one in the chat box if you can hear my voice clearly. Awesome. Thank you. Shout out to Gail, thank you for getting on the stream tonight. Shout out for getting on the thank you for getting on the stream tonight. We have a very interesting interesting subject to go over tonight. A sad one, but nonetheless, it's gonna be an informative one to the best of my ability. I'm gonna explore some different perspectives as it relates to the tragic loss of Mr. Stephen Twitch Boss, who was the DJ, well known as the DJ for the Ellen DeGeneres Show for a very long period of time. I believe he served as the DJ, then later became the co-executive producer for that show shortly thereafter, but I believe he had a career on that show for about 8 years, if I'm not mistaken. It was for a long period of time. He actually became the show, believe it or not. And in my personal opinion, I believe his presence on the show is what kept the show alive, because people came to the show not to see Ellen DeGeneres necessarily. They came to see Twitch because he had that kind of persona. This is him right here. Everything about this brother was cheerful, happy, excited, fun. They said when he walked into a room, he lit up the room. Like, there was no way for him to not be noticed when he walked into a room. That's how big and that's how bold his personality was when he walked into a room. Full of life, full of happiness, full of joy. He has spent his entire career as an activist, fighting for justice for many people. You know, many, many people. In particular, injustices that took place within the black community. This brother was bold, very outspoken, very controversial at times. But nonetheless, he had a heart and concern, a real heart and concern for justice, for those that have felt the sting of injustice. That's Mr. Stephen Twitch Boss, a very honorable brother, very happy brother, a husband, good husband, father of three, very successful career that he built from the ground up. TMX reported his tragic loss of life as a suicide. Well, personally, myself, I'm not buying it at all. I'm not buying it at all. And I'm going to show you some things tonight on this stream. And you can decide for yourself what you believe about this particular case, and more importantly, the story that's being spun, the narrative that's being spun about his loss of life. You decide, you the listener, you decide whether you believe that the narrative that's being spun, that Stephen Twitch Laurel Boss committed suicide. Or do you believe that perhaps something else may have taken place to cause him to lose his life? Perhaps others were involved. Perhaps something else was is to take responsibility for the loss of his life. I just can't see that a man this full of life, this happy with his life, who was such a huge inspiration to so many about fighting against struggles of life, staying strong, enduring, teaching about the joy of life, the joy of living. I can't wrap my head around the reality that he would go and take his own life, knowing that just 3 days prior to them discovering him in a inexpensive hotel just 15 to 20 minutes away from his home, that he would take his own life, forsaking the fact that he had a wonderful wife, a wonderful life, and 3 beautiful children that depended on him. There's video work of him, his wife, his children, decorating the tree in preparation of the upcoming holiday. There were gifts under the tree. I'm sure many of those gifts had his children's name on them, his wife's name on them. He was a doting father of his children. His youngest son, whose name was Maddox Laurel Boss. His children loved him, and he loved his children. And he loved his wife. I don't see that in even the last moments that he would not have thought about his children, who would have to endure the pain and the suffering of losing their daddy. I'm not buying it. I'm just simply not buying it. And you know, here's the funny thing. In this society, especially in particular when you're an entertainer, when the loss of life comes by some strange coincidence, be it real, imagined, or simply a concocted narrative, it's always dubbed as suicide. And you know, the saddest part about the narrative is that the public eats it up, swallows it, digests it, and goes on about their lives. No one ever asks the critical questions. Where's the investigation into the real reason? I don't care what the crime scene looked like. We've watched movies our whole entire lives. We've seen what can happen when a scene has been tampered with and made to look like whatever the perpetrator wanted the scene to look like, especially if you're professional. I don't believe that Twitch took his life. I don't believe it. There is no news report that's going to make me believe that. Nah, not at all. I'm not buying the narrative hook, line, and sinker. I'm not doing that. But I want you to be the judge. I want you to be the judge. And I want you to leave in the comment section where you think I went wrong, where I got it wrong at, based on what I'm going to show you during the course of this stream. I want you to watch his body language. I want you to watch his voice and what he says. I want you to pay attention. And I want you to use your own discernment of a person who would be in that type of mental state to take his own life, the level of depression, the level of hopelessness that exists in most who commit this kind of act against themselves. I want you to pay attention to him and what concerns him. So, and then come to a conclusion of what kind of person do you think this individual was? Do you believe, because I certainly don't, that he took his own life, forsaking his wife, forsaking his 3 beautiful children, forsaking the fact that just a few days prior to his alleged suicide, that him and his wife celebrated their 9th year anniversary. Considering the fact that they both danced together and videotaped it live on TikTok just days before. And considering the fact of what I just said earlier, that his whole entire family sat around a Christmas tree and decorated it together, all of them laughing and having a great time and smiling while they enjoyed a family moment of doing what they enjoyed to do together in preparation of the upcoming holidays. 9 days prior to the actual holiday itself, do you believe that he took his own life with no warning? No behavior that indicated any deep depression. No behavior with the wife he had been married to for 9 years, of whom gave him 3 beautiful children. Do you believe that he just decided, you know what? I'm out of here. I'm just going to check on out. Life is just too bad, too hard. I'm just going to check out. I'm just going to abandon my 3 children. I'm just going to abandon my 9-year wedding anniversary that I just happily celebrated just 3 days prior, 72 hours. I'm just going to abandon everything that I was enjoying happily and celebrating just days before. And in 72 short hours, I'm just going to check out. I want you to put in the comment section what you believe after I show you this stream. And I want you to get a good understanding of the kind of character, personality. And you tell me and you tell yourself, do you believe this man took his own life? Or do you believe there should be an investigation, a deep investigation? And I'll give you a few ideas of what that investigation should look like. Where's the footage for the camera system that was on the house to show him when he left the house? Since his wife stated that he left his car, something abnormal, that he never left the house unannounced and left his car. Where's the footage of the camera work, of the cameras that's attached to his home? I'm pretty sure he has a Ring camera system or some kind of camera system. Absolutely. Where's the camera footage at the hotel where he allegedly was found deceased in the bathroom by the maid at checkout time? Where's the camera footage of him entering the parking lot? What kind of vehicle was it? Who was driving? Was it him or was it someone else? Since TMZ came out and said that he got to the hotel by way of an Uber. Well, we know if you book an Uber ride, it's time stamped. What's the driver's name? Interview him. Where exactly did you drop him off? And did you drop him off at all? Or was perhaps he picked up by someone else that has not been documented? Why is it that no one heard the alleged gunshot? Since the manager of the hotel said that no one booked a room the entire week and that he was the only customer that booked a room, which means he was the only one in the entire hotel, which made the hotel an echo chamber. So if a gunshot was had in that hotel with no one in there but him, everyone would have heard that. Perhaps it wasn't a weapon without a silencer. Consider that. I'm just trying to get you to think about all scenarios before you buy into the whole narrative that this man took his own life. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I say justice for Stephen Twitch Boss. Husband of 9 years. Successful career with a net worth between $5 and $10 million. 3 beautiful children. I want you to decide whether you believe. Don't think from an emotional standpoint. Think from a logical standpoint, not an emotional standpoint. Because many times, oftentimes, if we think from an emotional standpoint, we tend to buy into whatever narrative is painted and we go with the flow. Emotions make you go with the flow. But when you think from a logical standpoint, you have to think outside the box. Think outside the box. What could be going on so badly with all of what I just described that he would decide to check out and take his own life? I'm not buying it. I am not buying it at all. And we give up too often. We give up often too fast before putting the pressure on law enforcement, putting the pressure on those that have the power and the leverage to investigate and find the facts. Whatever the media says, we go right along with it. Whatever social media says, we go right along with it. Like robots. Think outside the box. Now, I will tell you this. For justice to truly be had, and a real investigation to be had, sadly, and to my sad regret, it's based on his wife having the same feelings that I have and that many have right now, that there is potentially foul play involved in the loss of life of Stephen Twitch Boss, and that in fact he did not delete himself. That is a popular belief. Everybody hasn't eaten the bait and swallowed the hook. I'll tell you something, people, don't buy into the narrative. Don't buy into the narrative. If enough pressure, if enough pushback is given to the narrative that is trying to be painted by the mainstream media outlets, including TMZ, if enough pressure is put out there on the atmosphere, it just may get to his wife and make her change her perspective and insist upon an investigation into the death of Mr. Stephen Twitch Boss, of whom I believe did not under any circumstance take his own life. That is a lie. Someone is guilty of taking his life and staging it to look like it was a suicide. I'm telling you, those that say you are fans of Stephen Twitch Boss, those of you that say you followed him over the years as he worked as co-executive producer for the Ellen DeGeneres Show, those of you that remember him with the show he had called So You Think You Can Dance, those of you that know him and know his career, how it started all the way up until the point he became successful and became a household name and in fact became a brand, for those of you that say you are his true fans, step up and fight this narrative, this bogus narrative that he took his own life. At least put the pressure and the pushback against the narrative so that a real investigation can take place and we can find out exactly what happened to Twitch. We need to do that. Let's get into it. I'm going to show you some things. I'm going to read something first. Then I'm going to show you his very last video that he did within 24 hours of his being discovered as deceased. I'll put it like that. Let's get into it. Stephen Twitch boss's mother shares a heartbreaking message. This is his mother. And I want to say to his mother, Mrs. Connie Boss Alexander, and his father, Mr. Sanford Rose, all of whom originate from Montgomery, Alabama, I want to send my heartfelt, sincere condolences out to you for your loss of your son. Let's get into it. Connie Boss Alexander, which is his mother. And this is from an article that was put in People Magazine. The article was published by Kelly Wine on December 21st, 2022 at 3:11 p.m. That was today. Stephen Twitch's boss's mother shares heartbreaking message about her son in heaven. Connie Boss Alexander shared a past FaceTime with her late son, Stephen Twitch Boss, and a wish to connect in the afterlife. Stephen Twitch Boss's mother shared a tribute to her late son on Instagram Wednesday. The heartbreaking post featured a past FaceTime photo from a chat between Connie Boss Alexander and Stephen before his unexpected death. She pointedly captioned the photo, "Oh, if only I could FaceTime to heaven." Very sad. His wife, Allison Holker, and I want to send my heartfelt condolences to his wife and the mother of his three children, Mrs. Allison Holker Boss. I want to send my heartfelt condolences out to you. His wife, Allison Holker Boss, confirmed his passing in a statement to People. "It is with the heaviest of hearts that I have to share my husband, Stephen, has left us. Stephen, lift up every room he stepped into. He valued family, friends, and community above all else, and leading with love and light was everything to him. He was the backbone of our family, the best husband and father, and an inspiration to his fans." 2 days after Stephen died, Connie expressed her grief in an Instagram story post. "Family and friends, thank you for all your love and prayers and encouragement," she wrote. "Please know, I see all the messages, texts, posts, and the phone calls. I can't use words right now. Please know, I will reach out when I can." She added a line specific to her son, Stephen Laurel, "Your mother loves you to eternity and beyond." This is a picture of Twitch and his mother, who is still currently alive. This is her. That's him and his mother, who had a very close relationship. Not an estranged relationship, a very close relationship. This man had everything. Wonderful wife, three beautiful children, an amazing career. Him and his wife were working on multiple projects that were due to be unfolded in January. Everything was going in his direction in terms of success, solid family life, and a wonderful mother. You tell me, do you believe that he decided with all of that to delete himself? You decide. Along with Allison and Connie Boss is survived by his three children, Zaya, who's 3 years of age, Maddox, who's 6 years of age, and Wesley, which is his adopted daughter, who's 14 years of age. Now let's get into the actual report. Stephen Twitch Boss, body found in motel bathroom by maid after missing checkout time. This was an article that was published by Radar. It goes on to say that Stephen Twitch Boss was found dead by the maid of an Encino motel on Tuesday. Again, this was published by RadarOnline.com. The manager at Oak Tree Inn, who wished not to be named, tells us exclusively that Twitch checked into the motel on Monday, arriving at the modest, budget-friendly facility without a car. When Twitch failed to check out at 11 a.m. the following day, the manager said he sent the maid to his room, and she accessed entry with her key. He tells RadarOnline.com that the maid found the star's body in the bathroom. After informing the manager about the horrific scene, he dialed 911 to report a shooting. Now let's stop right there. Let's just stop right there. Something's funny. Something's weird about that. Okay? It says after, I'm gonna just go right back. It says when Twitch failed to check out at 11, I want you to listen to this. When Twitch failed to check out at 11 a.m. the following day, the manager said he sent the maid to his room and she accessed entry with her key. He tells RadarOnline.com, follow me, that the maid found the star's body in the bathroom. Follow me on this next thing I'm going to read. After informing the manager about the horrific scene, he dialed 911 to report a shooting. Let's stop right there. How did the maid realize it was a shooting or not? She never said she saw a gun. She never said anything like that. The report says that she went back to the manager to report a horrific scene, and then he dialed 911 to report a shooting. How do you know it was a shooting? Oh, it gets fishy as we go. However, he was unable to tell us where Twitch's wounds were. The manager tells us no visible suicide note was left, and yet they say, at least TMZ reported with no evidence. Shame on you, TMZ. Because one thing TMZ is noted for, when they give a report, they come with video and they come with receipts. They never come with just an allegation. Oh, but this time I guess it was okay, right, TMZ? You reported that a note was available, yet the manager says there was no visible suicide note was left, and yet law enforcement said they found one on the scene. So you tell me, who's lying about this situation? Who deleted Twitch and made it to appear as if it was a suicide? Let's go on. I'm not buying it. The manager tells us no visible suicide note was left, but Twitch did have a small bag with him when he arrived at the motel, which was found in his room at the time of his death. Sadly, the motel is just 14 minutes walk from Twitch's Los Angeles home. And yet, if you Google map the location versus where he lives, you know it's not walkable. You have to have a car. Oh, why'd they leave that part out? Let's continue. As RadarOnline.com reported, Twitch died from a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Fair use. On Tuesday, we can confirm his autopsy has been scheduled to take place today. His friends told us they were shocked and in disbelief over the news, adding their hearts go out to his wife, Allison Holker, and his children, Wesley Renee Holker, daughter who he adopted, Maddox and Zaya. Now, folks, already you can see the suspicions of the report. The manager tells us no visible suicide note was left. And yet, TMZ reported with no proof, that a suicide note was found on the scene, and law enforcement backed up that unverifiable narrative? What suicide note? And if you have one, let's see it. Let's see it. Don't say it. Let's see it. Especially when the manager said there was no visible suicide note. Let's see it. Don't say it. Let's see it. Because as it stands now, the narrative that he deleted himself, this will be the story that will be told to his children. This will be the ridicule and the mockery that they have to endure as they grow into older age, that your father deleted himself because he was a coward. You know how cruel people can be. I say justice for Stephen Twitch Boss. And I say, demand a thorough investigation. Put pressure, push back against this narrative. And perhaps it can persuade, and it will persuade, Mrs. Allison Holker, which is his wife, to insist upon an investigation into the loss of life for Stephen Twitch Boss, who had so much life ahead of him and so much success behind him and potential success in front of him. So much. I say we insist on a thorough investigation. Now let's get into this very last talk that he had just within 24 hours of his alleged suicide. Let's get into it. And I will tell you, folks, you decide. You decide. You look at this talk that I'm going to show you, and you tell me if you believe that this is what this man did. I'm not buying it. I'm not buying it today. I'm not buying it tomorrow. I'm not buying it at no time. I believe we need to start demanding proof for things, because I'll tell you something. One thing I can tell you about him, I've seen him, watched him, and he has always fought for justice. Always fought for justice. That's been his passion. And I don't believe that all of what he had and what God had blessed him with in his life, with how hard he worked to become the man he became in the end, and what God had blessed him in terms of his children, his wonderful wife, and so many other projects that he was working on that was due to be released and unveiled in January at the turn of the new year. I don't believe that he would just decide within 72 hours of having celebrated his ninth year anniversary with his wife, that he would just say, you know, I think I'll check out. Again, you write down in the chat box what you believe. Let's get into this video.
Yeah, I just wanted to say something real quick, man. I posted something yesterday.
This was done within 24 hours of his alleged suicide.
The Jacob Blake incident that happened, you know, seen the video, you know, read things all about it, and just I posted it to raise awareness and also just to share an outrage, man. This is happening too much, and even my caption said, is this routine becoming familiar? The routine of posting about unarmed black folks being brutalized, and then following up with the hashtag justice for fill in the blank. And then in the comment section, there everybody goes, well, what about, Twitch, don't post that. Don't divide us like that. don't push that narrative to it. It's like, yo, like I don't have to push the narrative. The narrative's already happening. And also for everybody that answered the post asking me about, well, what about the 5-year-old that was killed by this person? Yo, what happened to Cannon? That was awful. That was tragedy. That was tragedy. And justice is being carried out on the person that did that. If I'm not mistaken, the person that committed that atrocity is arrested and charged with first degree murder. We still yelling about justice for Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery,
fair use,
George Floyd.
Shout out to Melinda Henry for Elijah sharing this McClain. Content. YouTube commentator, reach out to him on YouTube.
Sandra Bland, Trayvon Martin, Samir Rice. Yo, I'm just Philando Castile. The countless others that are literally happening, it seems like every other week. But y'all want to get in the comment section and be like, oh, well, what about this? Like, why is it like when we're raising awareness on something that's happening against human rights, rather than just if you're going to leave a comment saying, you know, yo, that is messed up. Man, that's messed up. You got to go, yeah, but what about, almost like you're trivializing it. Like, it almost has this, like, this slight undertone, like you're a little tired of hearing this narrative. Oh, imagine that. Imagine that. That you're tired of hearing that narrative. Imagine that.
What's going on, everybody? What's happening? A couple of people kind of trickle in right now. How's everybody doing? All things considering, obviously. Sorry, my not straight at all, but I have to deal with that. What's going on, everybody? How we doing? Obviously. During this incredibly challenging time, like, I think information and conversation is currency, man. So what I'd like to do is bring in somebody that's been heavy in the activist space, in the space of activism, also an incredible dancer, an incredible dude, to just have some open dialogue on ways that we can help things that are going on. So I've got a Jade, if you're in here, bro, please send me a request, because I can't see your thing. It's my dude Jade Zuberry is his name. He'll be coming in. I'll just give a couple minutes. I'll vamp for a second. But y'all, this is listen. I don't have the perfect words to say about this at all. I feel like we've been speaking for a while, trying to find the perfect words to say to prove that our lives mean something. But you know, I do see that there's like a huge support from allies of various colors and backgrounds and things like that. So, and then also too, I want to address that too. Somebody just wrote, there are not the right words. You just speak from the heart, and you're right, but. You know, when doing that, I think sometimes on social media, people get really offended if you don't say the right thing. And obviously, because everybody's, really tense and sensitive. But I think we just sometimes got to be a little more patient with each other. There's Jade right here. Here we go.
You are most welcome to my YouTube channel. Make it a point.
Guys, all I want to do is say, rest in peace, Stephen Twitch boss, man. You know, a light that has been lost. The world just got a little bit darker. Because he was absolutely a light. You heard it. When he walked into a room, he lit the room up. He walked into a room. If you were feeling bad, you got a smile on your face. This man walked and exuded happiness. He exuded happiness in his own success and his own life. He inspired people to fight past their struggles, to fight past their setbacks, to persevere through the hindrances and the detours that would hinder them from reaching their goals. This man was a walking, talking example of what he spoke. And I'm happy to know that his birthday was the same day as mine. September 29th. Rest in peace, Stephen Twitch boss. You will be missed, man. And what I would say to every fan again, as we close this stream out, do not give up on justice for Stephen Twitch boss. Put the pressure, give the pushback for an investigation into his actual cause of death. Don't just buy into the narrative that this man deleted himself. Don't do it. Don't be so easily persuaded in what the media says about what happened. Don't you understand that there are professionals out there that if they want you deleted, they know how to go about doing it in such a way that'll make it look like whatever they need it to look like. I don't believe, again, as I close, I do not believe that Stephen Twitch boss deleted himself. Absolutely not. I do not believe it. I'm not buying it. I think we need to stop being so gullible, so easily persuaded by the media. Because if we are that persuaded by the media, I want you to imagine how many horrific crimes, how many horrific tragedies can be done at the hands of perpetrators who could be brought to justice, who will get away with doing whatever they choose to do to whomever they choose to do it to, as long as they can paint the picture, create this crime scene to look the way they want it to look. And if we go along with the narrative, justice won't be had. I say justice for Stephen Twitch boss. I say justice for you, man. And with that, rest in peace, my brother. Rest in peace. Guys, as you came into the building, hit the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe button, hit the share button. Let's get this message out. And again, as always, I thank all of you that got on the stream tonight. And I trust that we'll all make the right decision in getting in the fight for something. You know, if there's nothing to fight for, if there's nothing absolutely in our lives to die for, then there's absolutely nothing to live for. We have to understand that there are causes that we need to get involved in, either verbally, physically, or otherwise. But we just can't simply sit along the sidelines and do nothing and allow whomever, whenever, whatever, to paint whatever narrative they choose, while the victims go without justice, even to the extent that they lose their lives. We have to do better than that. We have to. Again, rest in peace to Stephen Twitch boss. Have a good night, folks. Thanks for getting on the stream. I am your host, Charles Chambliss. This has been another episode of Let's Talk About It Now. Until next time, have a good night.